And so I want to go back to something you mentioned earlier, and then I want to ask you about how you and your husband thought about your family financials. But you mentioned what things changed for you when you saw how female entrepreneurs were treated by angel investors. Can you give us a couple examples of that that you remember?
Oh my God, it was horrifying. So my first 2 years as an angel investor, I was with Sandhill Angels. And within a year, I was on the board. I was responsible for deal flow and partnerships with VCs. Because we put the early money in, but we had to have relationships with the VCs to make sure that we could pass those deals off for the next round to other investors to get additional checks. And there would be pitch events, or the founders would come in and pitch to us as a group. There were very few women who were a part of the group, and the women would get up there, and there were so many men in the room who would ask questions to make themselves look good and make the founders feel very, very small. And I often wondered about that whole dynamic. But there was one example in particular. It was a husband and wife, and the wife was the CEO, but it was a co-founder. So her husband was also there, and they had a device for the kitchen this was when these were all very, very popular, where you could set it up in the morning, have it set with a timer, or control it with an app so that when you got home, you actually had a hot, healthy meal, which was, it's important when you have two busy working partners, or your parent, you have a family, and so you're busy parents trying to feed, etc. And one of the guys said, I can't imagine, I don't know why people need this. I don't need something like this. Now, mind you, this guy was probably 60, 65. I don't think his wife had ever worked. They probably had some additional help within the house, people who were helping with the shopping and the cleaning and the food prep and everything else. And he couldn't practice what I call radical empathy to understand that somebody else might have a different lived experience.
That doesn't actually seem that radical for him to understand that some people have families where both partners work.
Yeah, and I'm like, how can you be a good investor if you can't imagine that somebody else might have different needs of your own, different needs from your own? But that was when I had discovered the concept of radical empathy, and I can't remember the author who coined the term, but it was like imagining that there might be someone who has a different lived experience from your own. And I saw a couple of times where some of the investors in the room asked just completely tone deaf questions. And I realized that the way that they asked the questions was tone deaf. And it was also very belittling to the founders who were presenting, especially if it was women. And I also saw that the questions that they asked the women were really more defensive and less about seeing what the opportunities are, less about seeing what the bigger vision was, to really fully understand what the opportunity was versus the way I saw them treating the men.